It's 12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
And on this week's show...
He got the biscuit before he barked.
He's
not going to do anything for the rest of his life.
Technically, he did do his practice bark before we started. But first of all, this week we've got Richard Sanders, a legend in magic.
With
his alpha deck, and you know, things come out from Richard Sanders, you automatically take notice and you go, I bet this is a good one.
It is.
Like the name tag one.
I love the price tag.
But this is alpha deck. What's the effect?
Well, it's a compendium of effects.
Yeah, there is a featured effect with some others.
Because I'd like to say now, it's not so much a deck. It's a compendium of effects with a blank deck, and you do get some of the gimmick cards with it.
I cut a few
gimmick cards with it, but not a full deck of them. So it says it's some tricks with a normal blank deck with some additional gimmicks. And some of them are quite strong.
What's the alpha deck? The main effect, the one we see on the trailer, so everybody knows. It's kind of like
half the deck goes to me, half the deck goes to the spectator. Bit of a do as I do type routine. You're going to take a card out, I take a card out, we swap cards, and we turn them over, and then we've both picked the matching cards, so the Ace of Hearts and the Ace of Diamonds, for example, and then we do it again.
And not only do you do it again,
people think, oh yeah, maybe all the cards are the same and maybe they're all aces or whatever. So we spread through the whole pack and then all the cards are then blank.
What did you think to it? It's kind of okay. The trouble is, I've got that effect by Stephen Bargetzi with the, you know, I hate card tricks. I keep banging on about this trick. I have been for 2 years. I do it. I work it. It's so strong because it's a thought of card.
Yeah.
And then the deck's blank at the end of it. If you want to do a blank deck, I still have not found anything stronger than that.
No, that's
effect.
It. It's brilliant.
That is the best version. What this kind of does, though, is simplify this, takes a lot of the thought out of it. It could be kind of self-working.
Yeah.
You do have to do a little bit of spectator management.
Yeah.
I think the second time, my concern would be, especially the people I perform for, maybe Richard's spectator are a bit of better behaved. My concern would be when they take out that second card, they kind of get ahead of themselves, they know what they're doing, and they turn a card over prematurely or something like that.
Oh my word, this was Richard Sanders.
And
I'm going to slap myself already for this, bam, saying bad things about Magic Legends. But if I'm going to be carrying around a gimmick deck or a blank deck, right, I want it to be really, 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 really strong because it's taking up that pocket space. And I'm thinking maybe I can do a stronger effects, if not stronger effects, with just a pack of cards. And so you could go out and you could go like 20, 30 minutes out of a pack of cards, and therefore when I'm then ringing in the blank deck or the gimmick deck, then it needs to be...
There are other effects which Sean alluded to earlier, like there's a brainwave routine where you kind of get spectators to put their hands around their back and then turn around a card, and it ends up the card they've turned around is the only card with a blue back, and then the only one they've turned around with a blue back, the rest of them are blank, and it's kind of like a bonus effect.
What about the audience management on that one as well? Would you be confident?
Sean made a point actually
that,
if you said to a spectator, you've got to hold the cards behind your back, which is what happens in this effect, and then they have to bring the cards out like this.
Hand them to you.
If they do that, the whole thing potentially could be blown. So
management. They have to bring the cards out like this. They can't bring them out and go, there you are, mate. If they do that, there you are, mate. Then the whole thing's...
And you said do it under a table. You'd be more likely to do that, which I thought was a good idea. So brainwave, we thought this might be very good. There's a routine called marked, which involved, again, all using the blank deck and a couple of regular cards. People, you riffle through the deck and they say stop and you show them a card. Somebody else says stop. It then ends up that those two cards that were chosen are marked in a different way, a different colour back. You can put a cross on the back, like Richard says, if you want to. The rest of the deck is blank.
The thing is, but with this as well, there's a lot of process with this.
Yes.
There's so much going on. I think
it's not simple.
I think in this for DVD, I think the Riffle Force is really overused in the DVD. I think someone like Richard Sanders, Richard could maybe think of other ways. I know that he could. He's a really clever magic guy. I know he could probably think of maybe better ways.
He does a blank deck version of Spectator's card at any number, doesn't he? Which is okay, but it's mostly Barry Richardson.
But he does credit Barry Richardson.
He credits Barry Richardson. There's other stuff on there as well. But if you're looking at it as that featured sort of alpha deck effect with all these others that are a bonus, I don't think you're going to get it and go, wow, this is like the trick of the year. And a lot of people tend to think that about Richard Sanders' effects when he's brought out things like
Ace. Price Tag, like we keep saying. That
Price
was like,
Tag was amazing. I don't think it's up there with those. I think if you're an amateur magician, you like magic to take down to the pub and show your mates, it might be the trick of the month for you, but I don't think it's something that's going to stay in your repertoire for a long, long time and be one of those trusted workers for you. I didn't like it. I wouldn't like to take the risk because you do have to manage the spectators a lot. I'll give it 64%, and I think I'm giving it a little bit more than I would if it wasn't Richard Sanders, but I kind of trust him, and it's kind of the respect to Richard.
Seriously, if I go below 64%, I'm being disrespectful.
Absolutely. What are you marking him?
I do respect him, but I don't think I can go as much as 64%.
Don't give him any more.
Because of so much process that's involved in the tricks. There's a lot of process. I think a lot of that could have been taken away. So I'm going to give it 62%.
Red Store's one of those effects that you kind of look at. It's got some arty bits on the trailer. You were like, the trailer's good. This is going to be a good one.
No, the trailer looks, can I say this? It looks like a kind of a mixture of an iStock video and then clips back at him in his room wherever he films his stuff from, sort of edited cleverly together. But it did look good. It looked like it was going to be a great trick.
So, what is the effect with this?
Do you know what? I'll start off by saying this. And I'm going to be really fair now.
Okay.
You being
it
a magician,
like gonna,
and you
going
knowing
for it.
No, the opposite. If you are being nice, if you're a magician, you're familiar with things like tour and the restored effects, and
I'm
therefore
familiar.
You would assume and you would jump the gun and you would go, "That looks like a tour and restored effect." Right?
Yes.
But it's not.
Right. No,
So you look at the picture and you assume it's, and therefore you might be let down with what it really is.
Yeah. Right? Well, I just didn't get it.
So what it really is, this is what it is. Is you're tearing a bit off a playing card.
Yes.
You're taking that bit and you're making that bit change colour.
Ah, right. Yeah.
And
it's
then
not apparent on the trailer, is it?
And then you're putting it back on again.
Yeah. Now, you're not restoring the card, are you?
You're not restoring the card because you're still leaving a great big tear in it. So the effect is you tear it off, you tear off a corner, you put the corner back on, but only you restore it on one side and the corner is going back on a different colour than what it could. But then when it got taken off.
John, I'll tell you, last week, John was saying to me, I think this looks good. It looks good. And I was like, I don't get it, John, because it doesn't actually restore.
Well, let's say this effect
doesn't restore. It's left unfinished.
And it is because. But let's be clear. This effect already has been brought out.
I'll grab a card so we can illustrate.
You illustrate it, and then because you know what I'm about to say about maybe something that's already out there. So let's do this. We're folding the card. So you're going to do this. You're going to fold the card. You're going to place a terror in it, just like this. You're going to then show it all this process and stuff that maybe doesn't need to be done anyway.
But it ends up like this.
You tear that bit off, and then you put it back on. Then that bit's blue, but it's still not restored there. So it's been torn off here. You take it off, you turn it blue, you put it back on. You restore that bit, and then you don't restore all that bit.
Yeah, you've apparently taken this bit and put it back on and gone like this. And then you give it to them and go, yeah, it's back on. And the first thing a British spectator's going to say at my residency is, well, you didn't put that bit back together.
Right, so here's the problem, right? Here we go, let's go. So I thought in my own mind, such a nice new package. I thought in my own mind, what is the solution? And I thought, well, the solution, rather than tearing the corner off, maybe what he would need to do is, tear the corner off like this.
Oh, right, okay.
And then it would have the, you could just have to restore one side, wouldn't you? And then I thought, it already exists.
That trick is already out
there.
It's
already out there, being done by incredible, well-known magicians. And so that trick, if you wanted to, you take that off, maybe turn its colour, turn it round, do whatever you want, put it back on. It's already there. We magicians are already doing
it's
it.
Out.
So what he's done is
well, he's thought of another way, but it's not as good as that.
He's thought of the way that you would have thought of before you improved it and made this way and brought it out.
Each time you do this as well with this trick, you have to spend about 5 minutes preparing it. To be fair, the instructional download, 25 minutes, that you get with the gimmicked part, mm-hmm. and we'll talk about that in a moment, is quite well explained. You've got to, I don't want to split hairs here, but you have to spend quite a lot of time explaining how to set this up and doing this kind of thing. It takes quite a while. But you do get the gimmick, and the gimmick means that you can cleanly show that corner.
Yeah.
And it's very much like a sucker punch gimmick, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because you've got that corner that is definitely blue, and it's just the only thing in your hand, but you can change it, and it will change to red, and it's still the only thing that's left in your hand, and then you put it on the card. And I think that's the best part about the trick, that you apparently tear off the corner. It then goes from red to blue or blue to red, and you put it back on there and restore it. That's the bit that's cool. The bit that's terrible that I just can't get past is once you've done that and apparently just been able to restore a piece of cardboard and fuse those molecules together, you go, I don't really feel like doing the other bit. I'll just leave it like that.
The only way around it is to tear the corner off diagonally and then pull it off, do it, and put it back on
again.
It's a
good idea. You should bring it out.
It's already out.
I know. So, how much are you going to give Red Store? Which is in, you look at the trailer, you think it's a good idea.
Here's the conundrum with marking this, is the trick does work.
Yeah.
It just, you can't do it because there's no end to it.
I think you could have bought it though, looking at the trailer, a little bit confused how it actually ends.
Yeah.
And what the trick actually is.
The trick does work, it's just there's no ending to it, so you can't do it. 54% from me.
Yeah, do you know what? I have to give this really low. I'm giving it 22. It's probably better than 22, but for me, it's like the trick is not finished. You just, every time, even if I did this trick flawlessly, even if I practiced for hours and hours and hours and I got it absolutely perfected and I did it, I would hand it over to the people I work for and they would just go...
And you're not going to do that bit. So next up, we have...
Silk to Egg.
Got Silk to Egg by J-Lo Miranda.
Pro
Silk to Egg.
Don't forget, because this is no normal egg.
No,
this
it's not normal
actually
egg.
It looks really good.
It looks like
if you're
an
familiar
egg.
With the Silk to Egg plot, this looks
this is
great.
The best looking Silk to Egg I've ever seen.
It's very, very it's good. Very good. You've got the white ones, you've got the brown ones, but you better watch out because...
Because it's so really, it's like the most realistic fake egg ever. Because and they've done this deliberately, years of planning, if you drop a real egg, what happens?
It breaks.
It smashes on the floor. What happens if you drop this?
It smashes on the floor into lots of bits.
Yes, it does.
Because the gimmick is ceramic. So, just kind of drops that in there in the explanation. It looks so good. It's great. But don't drop it because it will break.
It does. Ceramic.
We can confirm that.
Okay, so let's talk about that. We know that it looks great. We know that it's like maybe an ornament or something you're going to do once. Maybe it's good then. Maybe for a TV spot. If you want it to look really realistic for one bit, maybe it's great. Let's talk about the routines on there. Because you get two routines
on there.
He's got
a straightforward routine, hasn't he? Which is basically...
But you say straightforward.
He's got the one without the voiceover first.
I'd actually argue that
was
the least.
But it's the pro version, because it's going to fool magicians, this one.
It's so sad.
So the silk to egg effect, if you don't know it, first of all, you basically take a silk, put it in your hand, it ends up being an egg, and you then go, I bet you think it's inside, and you peel it off, and it's a real egg at the end of it. But with this, what he is able to do is show the silk, put it in his hand, and then show it straight away without going to his pockets or anything like that, and then immediately take it off. So it kind of is meant to streamline the whole thing. Is that fair? Does it do that?
No.
Why doesn't it do that?
It just doesn't. I love this effect. I used to do this effect in my first ever cabaret show. I've seen Michael Lamar did a great version of it. I've seen so many...
Christian Lee did it in the Magic Circle Christmas show. And it got a great
so
reaction.
So many magicians do this, and it gets an incredible
trick. Lance Burton.
And the reason that there's so much going on about this egg, and there's so much time that you can do where you need to do that dirty bit... And the bit that you need to do the dirty bit in this is just so... The trick's been ruined. It has been ruined. You can't... Well, I don't want it to give away any exposure or anything.
So well, you can see it on the live performance. It's obviously bad. It's obviously bad. It's obviously bad because they crop in, and if you've got this,
yeah, they zoom in on his chest.
If you, they know you can see it and see the move, and it's so obvious because suddenly the camera's on a master wide, and then it suddenly zooms into this bit, so you miss it. And I had to rewind it and thought, hang on. How did that actually work? I was genuinely fooled. And then I went back and looked. You weren't fooled. But I went back and looked at it. And the reason I was fooled with his first performance is...
Because he zoomed in
on
his chest.
All you can see is the edges of his hands.
And the magic happened over here. And they zoomed in on it. You couldn't see. You could just see maybe a bit of his finger there.
And you're not going to do this. You're not going to specially gimmick the pockets.
Now, the second routine, which is basically a rip-off of the Vanishing Bandana.
Yeah.
With the same jokes.
Similar gags that don't work.
And the problem is the jokes that you've been given in here don't actually work.
They don't work for a silk.
Because they've been crowbarred into it. So, for example, one of the funny jokes in the Vanishing Bandana is the banana's all squashed up. Everybody thinks it's hidden inside there. Well, because it is. And you say, and if an audience member does not believe this is a real silk handkerchief, allow him to wipe his face on it. And you go in, what's going on? Did do all that. And this one, well, now you've not crushed up an egg inside the silk.
No.
So therefore, the comedy doesn't work because you're now setting up a joke too much. So he now says, run the silk through your hands and now wipe your sweaty face on it. And now, you know, and now go and wipe it on a spectator in the audience.
The comedy
face
does not work.
Then remove the silk from the pocket and say, here I have a red silk.
Here I have a red silk.
A gentle and soft voice are very important to a great magician.
Here I have a red silk.
If the spectator doesn't believe that you're using a real silk, clean your sweaty forehead and give it for examination to the nearest spectator. Now that you feel better and everyone believes that you're using a real silk, remove the sweat with the other hand.
And you had a theory about where they'd got this voiceover done.
Yeah, I reckon they've got it done on Fiverr, right? Now hear me out. Right. Because I've done Fiverr. J-Lo Miranda obviously isn't English,
he's
from France.
He's not English.
So he's written a French person writing the script, and maybe some of the words, you know, what he would say when he was speaking, and because he's French, he's going, yeah, it's fine for him to say that. But this has been written down, it's sent to Fiverr, and they have delivered exactly the exact words have been written down.
You have hided it.
This is called misdirection. Now, in a natural and casual way, grab the fake egg from the place where you hided it before and palm it.
Is
that the word?
You have hided it. You hided it.
Hided it.
So anyway, words that don't really exist. Which obviously, if you were trying to do a high-level corporate and they thought that maybe you recorded that yourself,
yeah,
people would be cringing.
Look,
at that
it's
point.
It's a lot of money, isn't it, for a silk-to-egg routine?
How much is it? About £30?
It's expensive for what it is, yeah. Even though it's a ceramic egg, that means you could break it. There's other silk-to-egg gimmicks out there. The pro version of it is this handling that even he doesn't feel stands up to, you know, a nice wide camera shot, and he has to zoom in and hide the move. And when he's explaining the move,
it's terrible.
During that, we can't
you just
say
can't do it.
He can't do the move.
He can't do the move. And do you know what's really weird?
I'll tell you what's really weird. He's been doing it for 15 years.
He has been doing a lot of tricks for 15 years.
Yeah.
I don't want to say anything, but I'm just going to talk to you.
Yeah.
I don't understand why you can't make that. The move is the wrong move to do at that point. But
yeah.
I'm going to stop talking. It's under exposure. It's just terrible. You can't do it. Then now, in the second routine, which is a bad comedy routine, it is a better way of doing the dirty bit. A much better way. It's almost like more towards the normal way of doing the dirty bit. It's just the routine doesn't work. My thoughts are there was a lot better, like Michael Amar's thing where, you know, pull the hanky, you peel
which
the
David dog. Williamson
ah,
did.
No, something else, the big finale, that where you peel the dot off. Right.
Yeah.
Does that dot look like a bit of handkerchief hanging out the
end? No.
What does it look like?
A shiny orange sticker.
And it does. The light is reflection. There's nothing about this. You know, they'll be able to get to the end of it. It's like he's forgotten what the effect's meant to be. The effect is meant to be that that is the silk still hanging out of the back of the trick egg, and then you peel it off, and then you do whatever with it,
right? It's almost like he's gone, this is a great egg. I can make this egg. We can produce this egg as a company now. Like, quickly, let's get a routine behind it. Let's call it a pro, and let's flog it for this month's product.
Yeah.
That's all it is, isn't it?
Yeah, well, maybe if you were going to get that, maybe you'd have a chat with somebody like Mike Lamar and do it with a download with the instructions for his egg and have a great professional
routine. I don't believe
routine.
He's been doing it for 15 years. Send us a video. He must have a video. They have video. He's one of the most advanced magic companies in the world. You know, his blackboard, his watches, everything is so advanced by this. I'm sure he had a video camera 5 years ago. 5 years ago?
5 years ago?
We'd be happy if we had a video
from
five years ago. Let's see one for
cabaret.
5 years ago from Cabaret. You know, a bit longer hair, looking completely different. Maybe even 2 years ago. Let's see a video. He's been doing it 15 years. I'd like to see a video, yeah. Show us. Tell us we're wrong. We'll apologise to you live on camera. Because I doubt he's been doing this for 15 years when he can't get it once right on the instructional download. How much are you going to give it?
I reckon if you got like a rubber stop,
yeah,
you might get a whole, it'd be a great salt shake, wouldn't it?
Could be. That's another product for next month. Just need a routine. How much are you going to give it?
Here's the problem, right? Social media network cards. I think you did them last week, right? Right, watch this, right?
Oh, sorry.
I can still use it tomorrow. That is definitely going to happen. 2%, because it doesn't work. If you drop it once, you can't ever do it again. You've smashed it.
I'll give it a little bit more than that. If only it reminded me how good the silk to egg trick is when you do it the normal way.
Before you give your say your score, because you didn't say your score yet, you said you'd give it more than that. If you did get this egg, right, would you go out and do any of the routines that come with it?
No, I'm not
so
going
So what are you
going
to give it?
Well, the egg looks okay, so it might be all right for TV, but I'll give it 3%. 3%. It's well, you could drop it.
Average of 2.5.
Routines are terrible. They're painful to watch. Painful.
So, from one classic of magic to another, we've gone from the vanishing silk to egg pro to the vanishing glass of milk
pro.
Pro.
And we're going to say up front, this is getting a worker of the week.
Yeah.
Because we're very impressed with the quality of this prop. We like that you can use it as a children's magician.
Yeah.
We like that you could use it as an illusion show front of cloth if you wanted to, which I like. It's a great compare piece. Now, you may have seen something like this before, and even though we're doing it right now and kind of demonstrating it, we'll put footage on the screen. It is amazing how you make that glass completely disappear, Sean. It is amazing how
Thank
you
do
it.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you, team.
It's a sucker trick in the sense that you have the glass, and you can actually put milk in this glass as well, can't you? You can put milk
in
there if you use the milk text stuff. And you cover it over, move it over there, do the secret move. Yes, it's gone completely this time. And then it's obviously behind the curtain. And at the end, you can show that glass completely vanish. Now, we have just literally picked this up, started playing with it. We are so impressed with the quality of it.
Brilliant.
The quality of the gimmick is absolutely fantastic. It's really, really good. Now, I remember going back to a kid at the Northamptonshire Magicians Club, a guy called David Bars, who I haven't seen for many years. And this was one of his featured effects.
Yes.
And it's one of those effects that's gone, it was popular for a while, maybe like 20 years ago. Mm. And then you just don't see a gimmick. And you certainly don't see one of this quality. And we'll put clips on the screen where you can see the milk actually inside the drink. So you could start with a milk carton, like you're filling it up. You cover it over, put the tube on. And what David had, I always remember, where he got the tube like that, he had a lower tube around it, and then it was another tube over the top.
Mm.
And what made that good, and you don't get the extra tubes with it, but I bet you could easily use drain pipe or something. He said, you know, it vanishes from tube number one, it vanishes from tube number three, and it vanishes from tube number two.
Yeah.
And he would basically show each tube. And because of the rule of three, the timing would work really, really well. And when it dropped down in there, And it is a great sucker trick because they see it there. Even Paul Daniels used to use it.
His
early days when he was Ted Daniels. Because if you watch the documentary, we had this for review, and the documentary, the Channel 5 documentary that was on the other night, it showed a black and white photograph of him, and there he was doing it. In India.
I think we have to remember about this is it is such a strong visual moment at the end because you condition the audience to see that the milk is underneath there. Now, this you can either do however you do it, because obviously it's a bit of silliness. However you do it, they're used to seeing it there. So that moment when you whip the cloth away, it really is a visually stunning piece moment for the audience. And it really is. And I think as magicians, we might be too quick to look at this and go, oh, it's that silly children's trick. But I know for a fact, if you're doing a middle bit comparing a show, that if you do that, the minute when that comes away, the audience, you will get that from them.
If you take the cover off, you're instantly into that applause position with nothing left in between. And what is it Jeff Durham says? Anything with liquid involved automatically becomes a better trick.
Yes,
and he's right, you vanish the glass of liquid. Forget what you might know about this gimmick that you get with it. To the public, that's a glass full of milk. It's just disappeared. And you showed them how it was done. You've got the sucker trick. Then I would advise you to put the more tubes around the top. But the gimmick itself works absolutely flawlessly. And it's so, so well made. You need to get yourself some milk text. And just for full disclosure, you need to get yourself a syringe from the pharmacy to make sure that you've prepared your glass and it's a full glass of milk ready for the performance. But at the end of that, you've got a worker and you've got something that's guaranteed to give you applause. I almost wish I was doing children's shows and it was Christmas coming up, which it is, and I was doing children's shows and I thought, right, that's going to be one of my bits for this year that's different to this year.
Get a glass of milk to leave out for Rudolph in the morning, aren't you?
The routine's already there. You're already writing it. Now, this is getting a worker of the week. The quality's there. It's a great effect. It's going to get guaranteed applause and it's made so well. Like, the quality of these tubes.
Brilliant.
Really, really well made. The table, it's like metal, isn't it? They're all magnetised on there. It needs those outside ones, so you're taking them off. Tube number one, tube number two, tube number three. And that works even better. I hope you know what I mean there. Like a slightly lower one and then a wider one. So it's like one on top of another. Then you get the timing of the routines even better. But I've not seen anything this quality before for this effect.
That's brilliant.
For a number of years. It's just come up for review. Really, really, really great effect. Now, it's actually a double worker special.
What are we going to give it?
Oh, I'm giving this 94%.
Yeah, 98% for me.
It's a really great effect. Because it's not a cheap item, we've decided to give it two products for the worker of the week. First of all, if you're wanting stage magic for Christmas and there's no better person than Mark Short, than one of the leading comedy magicians in the country. I know we've had that before as a worker special, but it's a double DVD set on and off stage with Mark's number one set there, including his bullet catch routine, which is unbelievable.
Which he won the British Magical Championship.
Absolutely unbelievable routine. Now, because we were saying about Silk to Egg earlier as well, and we felt a bit bad sort of leaving you with, well, you want this Silk to Egg routine, you perhaps wanted to do the Silk to Egg, and we've reminded you how good it was, just like it did for me. And then I remembered that actually Craig Petty's Parlour DVD, produced by World Magic Shop, has got a fantastic Silk to Egg routine on there, where you can get just a normal Silk to Egg gimmick and do that routine and not even worry about dropping it and breaking it. And if you order the Vanishing Glass of Milk Pro from worldmagicshop.com by Friday at midnight, you'll get these two DVDs shipped automatically with your order. I believe about £50 worth of product shipped with your order for free, absolutely gratis, as long as you order that from worldmagicshop.com. It's part of the worker special. Friday at midnight is when it comes to an end. I was just stopping my train of thought there because I did remember that Ali Cook has invited us to his show in Birmingham this week. So if you're around, go to Ali Cook's website. And later on in the week, myself and Sean are hoping to be there. So try and get to see Ali Cook on his Principles of Deceptions tour. There's a big tour going on. He's going all around the country. But you might well just see me and Sean there at the Principles of Deception show in Birmingham. Hope to see you there. And we'll see you next time on the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
See you next time. go.